What about the new album Sacrifice? I understand that the video was banned from a lot of places.
Jesus Christ. Why everybody's worried about Nazis when it's the communists you should be worrying about? I don't know. Like, who's Nazis anyway? If you get a Nazi today, he wouldn't wear a Nazi uniform, you know what I mean? He would be just as a businessman. Yeah. Those are the Nazis, baby, you believe me. It's just like, it wasn't our idea, the director did it, I thought it was excellent. It also has Stalin and Mussolini in it, you know. We missed out on Juan Perón, but, you know, maybe next time.
In this album, more than never before, you are just taking the subject of war.
Read about war, right? I mean, who do you like from history? You like Louis Pasteur or Adolf Hitler? Who's more interesting to read about? You don't read about Louis Pasteur, man. The discovery of penicillin. Although you're really glad if you go to the clock clinic, you know, but like, you want to read about Attila the Hun, you know, it's the more interesting, right?
So. Could you say that war is an obsession for you?
No, it's an obsession for mankind. I'm just one of them, you know. Everybody likes war, man. Look at the Yugoslavia. You know, they love that shit. They love to kill each other. People love to screw each other up, you know. Somebody to blame, you know. It's an unfortunate thing, but it's humanity, it's not just me. If you think it's me, look.
Ozzy Osbourne was here last month. He spoke fantastic about you, about the relation you got with him. You wrote a song with him for his new album. So, did you ever think about making a project with him?
We did one on March or Die.
But I mean a whole project.
No, not really. He's busy, we're busy, you know. We maybe do that after we stop touring. And we're both too old, crutches, you know, in a wheelchair, you know, we can do it then, maybe.
Okay. After all these years, do you think that the spirit of rock and roll is still with you, around you?
It is in Argentina, it's great, you know. I hope the Argentina crowd never gets too smart about rock and roll. I hope they never have too much rock and roll, you know, because it's great, as it is, it's perfect, it's a great audience. It's the best audience in the world right now. Like, Argentina entertains us. And then we entertain them better. You know what I mean? It's like give and take with the audience and the band. That's how it should be. But in the rest of the world, it's like, you know, I've seen this, you know, it's bullshit, you know, that attitude.
Do you think that the media is ignoring the hard music, the heavy music today, nowadays?
Yeah, they took Headbangers Ball out of American TV. They don't have any anymore. They took it off the air. So there's no rock and roll. Some of rap music and house music and shit like that, you know, technical, like, studio trickery, garbage, you know.
Would you say that...
remember a dance mix tune in 20 years, you know what I mean? You're singing the Beatles song still, you know, you would never remember any of this shit, you know. You might remember us, but you won't remember techno. You know?
Everybody will remember Ace of Spades anyway.
Oh, I hope, more than that, I hope.